Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I just got a Corsair Vengeance Pro RAM, which is 16 into 2 GB kits, and this is 3200 mAh and clocked at a CL16. So I'm assuming that this is going to help me in performance boost during my video edits and other workflows. I thought to upgrade to 64 GB kit, but I think that was like overkill. I don't have that much requirement of RAM, but you know, Adobe softwares are RAM hungry, so will manage in 64 GB. So earlier I had 32 GB RAM in the stock, so it's going to be double. So let's see how is the performance boost. But before that, unboxing karte hain. Chaliye. So ye raha hamara RAM ka do stick. Actually, it wasn't available in like 16 into 2 kit, so I had to buy it separately. But the price was same. He gave me a Best Buy. The price has been increased a little bit from last year when I got my stock 32 GB kit. So bad timing. But anyways, let's unbox it. What is this? सेफ्टी इन्फॉर्मेशन बम वम है क्या इसमें भाई हैं गजब रैम में क्या सेफ्टी इन्फॉर्मेशन फिर भी ठीक है चलिए ओके ये रहा अपना रैम किट पहले वाला मेरा वाइट कलर का है ये ब्लैक है आई थिंक फंक्शनली कुछ डिफरेंस नहीं होना चाहिए सो चलिए एक मिनट इसको साइड रखते हैं दूसरा डब्बा भी खोलते हैं So this RAM is Vengeance RGB Pro. This is not SL. There is a slight difference in the timings in SL and normal Pro version. Anyways, so now we'll go and then plug it in my workstation. Well, why you need to enable DOCP in BIOS is just because by default newly plugged RAM sticks with higher speeds are downclocked to base 2100 mAh in Ryzen CPUs. So to maximize performance boost and take advantage of the faster RAM, you need to enable DOCP in BIOS to auto overclock it. Enabling DOCP takes care of rest of the settings automatically and you just need to save changes and exit. Your system will restart and then you can head over to Task Manager and check the updated RAM speed. So now you can see that the RAM is now updated to 64 GB and the memory speed is also tweaked by enabling DOCP in Asus UFI setup. So all the RAMs has been set up and there is no issue and they are synced as well.
Another crucial tip before you buy new sticks is to match the same model and make to avoid any system instability issues. So if you had 16 into 2 sticks at 3200 mAh, for example, then go for the same modules while upgrading to match the specs and let it perform efficiently. RAMs actually doesn't do good when they are mixed match with different speeds and capacities. So be careful before you take a decision to upgrade it. That's all folks in this one. Happy upgrading, and if this video helps you, then give it a thumbs up and see you in the next one. Peace. Bye-bye.